HiReport.com. So, Kathleen Sebelius was basically being interviewed in Capitol Hill getting grilled by a congressional committee on the healthcare website and the healthcare law. And unbeknownst to Kathleen Sebelius, the website crashed as she was giving testimony. And, you know, honestly, I'm going to be blunt here. This website is truly representative of this Affordable Healthcare Act, or Obamacare. It is a flop. It wasn't even a one-hit wonder. You know, and the fact that this website, from the get-go, just did not work, it should tell you, the viewer, that I don't think that Obamacare was ever meant to work. The fact that premiums are going up, the fact that people are losing their health insurance in general, because healthcare providers need to provide for all these other instances of medical care that you know, like birth control. Why in the world would I need birth control? You know, again, you know, it shows you whoever thought of this law was not thinking straight. But part of the problem is that we, the American people, are not holding accountable our elected leadership. We're not holding accountable President Barack Obama. We're not holding accountable Congress. We're not holding accountable Kathleen Sebelius. Yes, we'll yell and scream on YouTube and make an iReport video like this one, but guess what? That's as far as it'll go. The level of contempt that Congress has towards the American people is beyond belief. The fact that they can exempt themselves from this healthcare law should tell you just that. And it should tell you also that the American Congress has been bought. The fact that they can exempt themselves and believe themselves to be beyond the scope of their citizenship, it's the level of contempt, I believe, that they have towards the very document that they swore to uphold. Now, I know that almost every video these days, I wave this document around. It's called the Constitution. It's the very document that they swore to uphold by oath. And the fact that no one's holding account to that oath should show you and tell you that we have a problem here, people. The media is not doing its job in telling the American people the truth. And the fact of the matter is this. The United States is being looted. It's being looted by this healthcare law. It's being looted by the bankers. It's being looted by our Congress. It's being looted, yes, even by our president. And the fact that no one's raising an eyebrow about it is beyond and beneath contempt. And it shows you that the American people are asleep. We're too busy watching Dancing with the Stars, no offense, or some reality show with Kim Kardashian, no offense. We're too busy, you know, just, we're not in tune with reality. How bad does the debt have to get before someone realizes that the United States is in trouble? When Ron Paul campaigned initially back in 2008, you know, and he said, you know, we're amassing this huge debt that we can't pay off, you know, no one listened to him. And I'm not trying to say, hey, vote for Ron Paul or anything like that. That's nonsense right now. But the fact that people ignored him, the fact that people laughed at what he was saying, it shows you how out of tune and out of reality people are. Now, my apologies for ranting, but I'm an American citizen. I am concerned about my country. I'm concerned that my grandchildren, great-grandchildren, my nieces, my nephews will inherit a huge mess that we've created, that we've helped create. And because we don't hold our president accountable, we let our president dodge blame, we let our Congress exempt themselves from reality and the law that they actually pass or legislate, we allow our government to run amok. We allow our congressional leadership to be bought. We allow a banking system to print money out of thin air, not backed by anything, and we're wondering why we're in such a mess. You know, like I said, I'm an American citizen, and I am angry. I want our republic to function like the way it was intended to. Not to operate like, you know, it's a world policeman passing laws that its congressional and political leadership are exempt from. Sending our military all across the world for no apparent reason other than to defend some old man's money. You know, and all the while, our young men and women of our military are being killed. You know, if the American people woke up to this reality, I can guarantee you, things would change in a heartbeat. But until we actually listen or pay attention, guess what? It's just a conspiracy theory, I guess. Peace.